गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम सोमशेखर एम एस फ्रॉम दिलंबिका गर्ल्स हाई स्कूल सिरिगेरे। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी आर डीलिंग विद द 10th स्टैंडर्ड इंग्लिश रिगार्डिंग द सप्लीमेंटरी रीडिंग नारायणपुर इंसिडेंट। वी ऑलरेडी लर्नड वन सब यूनिट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द सेकंड सब यूनिट। सो नारायणपुर इंसिडेंट वॉज हेल्ड ड्यूरिंग द freedom movement during the 1942 quit india movement, the year 1942 quit india movement. So during that period a teacher of a school had been arrested who was the follower of the Gandhiji. As a result of this, the teacher's son Mohan and his classmates, friends made a protest against the British, against the arrest of their teacher. So they went in a procession, a long procession. There was a crowd of people watching the students because the students went silently without slogans and shouts. They went silently near the DC office. There was a barricade. They were stopped there. A DC was making a conversation with him. He spoke something. The students argued with him. At last, the student leader handed over the piece of paper to the DCP. He took it in his pocket without glance at it. The students turned back. Seeing this way of protest, Mohan's brother and sister Manju and Babu were disappointed because they expected the protest should be violent. There should be some shouts and slogans, but it was complete silence. That's why they were disappointed. So today we'll continue the same lesson. What is the response of the Mohan for this silent procession? So after his return, Babu asked Mohan, "Why did you go back so quietly? Were you scared of what police would do? Because the way along it was covered by the police." Mohan seemed immensely pleased with himself. Scared? Not in least. We had planned in this way. We knew they would stop us at the gate. We knew they expected us to protest and be violent. Ah yes, they wanted us to do what so that they could beat us up and haul us away to jail. But we are not prepared to go to jail. Not as yet. Anyway, not until we are given them much more trouble. And so we decided we would give them no chance at all. What was the point then? Babu asked. While Manju listened earnestly in her chin cupped in her hands, "It is like declaration of war. We have told them this is a war for us and you are the enemy. You don't start a war without first declaration your intention, do you?" Yes. To the question of the Babu, who asked, "Were they scared of police? Were you feared about the police?" Mohan's replied, seemed immensely pleased with himself. He was very happy with himself, the way they protested. He said, Scared, fear? Not in the least. We didn't have a little scare about the police. We never scared about the police. We are very dare. But we had planned in this way. Why the procession went silently? Because the Mohan and his friends made a plan to make the procession very silently, make the procession or protest very silently. Though it is a protest against the British, that should be went silently without any violence. That was the plan they have made. Because of that, they made a silent protest against the British. Because they knew, Mohan and his friends knew What did they know? They would stop us at the gate. Definitely they would be stopped at the gate. There is with the barricades. And also they knew they expected. They means the police, British police expected us to protest and be violent. What was their expectation? The police expected the students will protest in a violence. They will shout. That's why, yes, they wanted us to do so. That's so they could beat us up and haul us away to the jail. So what was the expectation of the British police? The British police expected the students' protest should be violent. If they are violent, then it will be easy for the police to beat the students and haul to the jail. Then only they can take away to the jail by dragging them to the jail. That's why, if we are violent, then only they are able to, they will give a chance to beat them and haul them to the jail. That's why the student leaders had planned they should not give the chance to the police to beat them or to haul them to the jail, take them to the jail. That's why the whole protest was in silent. Yes, they wanted us to do that so that they could beat us up and haul to the jail, away to jail. But we are not prepared to go to jail. So why it was silent? Because the student leader were not ready to go to jail. Yes, not yet. At this time, we should not go to jail. Because, anyway, not until we have given them much more trouble. We have to give them trouble. So now we are starting to give them trouble. We have to give more and trouble. We have to trouble the police for a long time. If you want to trouble the police for a long time, you should not go to jail. So that's why the way they took the protest was silent. Otherwise, if you made something violent, definitely they would put into jail. Then they could not do anything against the British. If they are now outside the jail, they can give more and more troubles in so many ways. That's why the procession or the protest went silently. And so we decided, we would give them no chance at all. So the students leaders had decided we should not give any chance to the police to beat us or to haul away to the jail. Moreover, the silent protest was purposeful because the police expected them to be violent. That's why they wanted to protest silently, so they could not put into the jail. They will be out of the jail, then they can give more and more trouble to the British if they are in the jail. So after listening to this, Babu asked, what was the point then? If you are silent, if you are protesting silently, then what is your point? What is your aim? Yeah. So while asking this question at Bhagavad, Manju, their sister, listening carefully, attentively, her chin cupped in her hands, by putting like this, her cheek in her hands, she was listening earnestly. It is like a declaration of war. This protest is just a declaration of war. Yes, we are making a fight with you. We have told them, the students have told them, this is a war for us. They have announced, this is a war for us. For us, it is a war. And you are the enemy. They clearly told in the piece of paper, this is a war for them. And who are the enemies in the war? Yes, the British were the enemies. You don't start a war without first declaration of your intentions. We can't make a war at once. So before starting a war, we should have some intention with purpose. With a particular intention, we can start the war. That's why you can't put a war without intentions. Do you? You ask the question. That's why we had an intention. Our intention was to give trouble to the British more and more. If you want to trouble more and more, you should not go to jail. That's why they protest silently. unless you are Adolf Hitler, Amma. Who had been quietly listening to them, said with a small smile. So while they were conversing with themselves, the brothers, Mohan and Babu, their mother also listened to them. She replied, unless you are Adolf Hitler, unless you are Adolf Hitler. You might have known about the Hitler in the history class. Adolf Hitler was from Germany, isn't it? How was he ruled? How he took the holding of whole country to protest, is it? Like Adolf Hitler, you should be bold in your decision. Then only he can keep away the British. If you want to fight against the British, you should be like Adolf Hitler. Adolf Hitler, you might have known. So, you are a very popular person in the world history. He was a major person who was the cause for the Second World War. For the World War, he was one of the major person. So, Adolf Hitler was a ruler, not like a democratic way. So, he fought against the other countries in his own way. What he thinks it is right. Dictatorship. He was a dictator. Adolf Hitler was a dictator. If you were become like Adolf Hitler, like a dictator, then only you can be able to fight the against the British Amma side. Listening quietly to them, said with a small smile. This small smile, she replied, you have to be Adolf Hitler. Right. Which were not. So, that's how it was. And what was that paper you gave the policeman? Right. The Manju said, you are right. Which were not that. You are not, I know you are not Adolf Hitler. So, that's how it was. But how it was? And what was that paper? What was that paper you gave the policeman? Yeah, give yao. Submitted some paper to the policeman. What was that paper? Mohan replied, that was a notice served on the collector. This was a notice given by the students to the collector of the district as a representative of His Majesty's government. Because in this district, the district collector is the representative of His Majesty's government. Because who was the Majesty? As British King and Queen were their Majesty. That's why it was as a representative of the Majesty in the district, who is the head collector. So they have given a notice to the collector asking them. So what was asking the letter? Quit India or face the consequences. So what was the notice served by the students? The notice served by the students to the collector as the representative of the British, they have clearly noticed that quit India. They have to get out of the India or face the consequence. They have to face the as a consequence that come after the problems. So he has clearly told the British should quit India. Otherwise, they have to face the consequences of that as a result of it. That was the notice served on the collector, quit India, face consequences. Suman and another boy turned up after they had finished their dinner that night. Suman and other boy, Suman, their friend, Mohan's friend and other friend, other boy, turned up after they had finished their dinner that night. They have made a dinner and come to the Mohan's house. The boy staggered in with a large newspaper covered box in his hand. The boy was staggering with, so he was while coming, they had a parcel, the boy. He was not walking properly, he was staggering while walking. A large newspaper covered parcel. They have a parcel. The parcel was covered with a newspaper covered parcel in his hands. Got it? Manju asked him. Sorry, Mohan asked him. What did you say? When Suman and the boy came with a large parcel, Mohan asked him, got it? You have got it? The voice stands with voice, there was a tense of excitement while Mohan asking this question. Yes, lot of trouble. It is not so easy to get it. There is a lot of trouble, though we got it. Where shall I take it? Where shall I take the parcel? Here, let me help you. Let me help you. My room okay, Amma? Mohan said, let me help you. My room okay, Amma? No. Amma said, no, your room is not okay. I think Pooja room is better. Because Pooja room is better. Your room is not good. Somebody will watch you in the room. So, Mama suggested Pooja room is better. A light there will be more normal. The light in the Pooja room are not so bright. It is little bit dim. So, Pooja room is better. She said, right as usual, Amma. The Pooja room then. The boy went away after whispered conversation with Suman. So, the boy put the parcel in the Pooja room and made a whisper conversation. What is whispered? Speak in a low voice. He spoke to the Mohan in a low voice and went away. So then, after this boy went away, Suman, Amma and Mohan went to the small Pooja room. All the three went into the Pooja room. Who are there in the discussion? Their mother, Mohan and Suman, all the three went into the Pooja room for the discussion. What did they discuss? What did they discuss? Went to the Pooja room. Babu and Manju stared means looked curiously over their shoulder at the mysterious parcel. What is this? That boy has brought something with a paper covered parcel. Mohan said it should be put in his room. Amma said no. Pooja room is better. The parcel was put in a Pooja room. After this, the boy went off. Mohan, Suman and their mother were making a conversation, like a meeting in the Pooja room. So, they were very curious. Babu and Manju are very curious. What was that thing? What was that parcel? What was this mysterious, which is a secret parcel? What was that parcel? Asking them, mysterious parcel. What was this meeting, mysterious parcel? What was this? Which turned out to be a cyclostoling machine. What was the mysterious parcel? That mysterious parcel was a cyclostoling machine. Cyclostoling machine was a kind of machine which makes the copies of the one print. So previously, before the Xerox machines come, so most of the schools, colleges, offices used to make the number of copies with the help of the cyclostoling machine. Cyclostoling machine is a very simple machine. In which, if you make a typewriting machine, we took the copy of it. With the help of that, we can get the more and more number of copies of whatever you want. So that's the question. One is, what was the mysterious puzzle? Yes, the mysterious puzzle was cyclostoling machine. Remember, this is a very important question. We'll be asking this. Babu and Mohan said, as they settled down to work, sit out in front of the room, keep watch. So they sit to work. Who sit to work? Mohan and Suman sit to work. They asked Babu and Babu. Babu asked, settle down, sit out in the room, sit out in the front of the room, keep watching. Mohan asked Babu to sit out in the front of the room and keep watching. If anybody else comes towards the house, inform me. Give us warning. If anybody seems to be coming to our house. Babu gave a work to Manju and the Babu. What was the work? Babu has to sit in front of their house and keep watching. They have to inform, they have to warn Mohan and his friends if somebody else seems to be coming towards their house. Manju, go to bed. He asks Manju, he gave the work to the Babu and asked Moshe to go to bed, or else he went on. Or else, he said, he went on. Noticing her crestfallen face. So when he told Manju to go to sleep, her face was something lost shining. She was become dim. After seeing his face, he said, you sit here in the hall. So you don't worry, you can sit here in the hall and pass the Babu's war. Because Babu will be sitting in front of the house, he will pass the message to you. You can pass his message to us, you can do this. Like this he told. Babu sat outside. How did he sit? Alert, attentive. Babu sat outside the house, very alert. He was very careful who is coming. So what he was doing? Very attentive he was watching. He felt thinking in his thickening his throat. It was beginning. At the last, he was doing something. What a pity Gopya, Murli and others would never knew about the perhaps someday. He felt proud of him because he too was working for the freedom of our country. He too was doing some little job to the persons, Mohan and the friends. He is in this way. He is also serving the country in his own way. He thought to himself, he was very proud. But his friends, Piti, Gopya, Murli and other friends don't know anything about it. They don't know anything what this Babu was doing. Yes, how the Babu was helping the freedom fighters in his own way. They don't know, they little knew about this. Perhaps someday they will come to know how I helped. He checked himself and keep his eyes and mind on the road. Kept his eyes on the road, mind also on the road outside. It was desert. It was desert, means there was nobody on the road. It was completely empty. The road was completely empty. In a little while, the 9 o'clock siren went off. The little while, 9 o'clock, there was siren. The siren went off. If your siren sound heard, it means it's a 9 o'clock night. Babu thought for the first time that day was the war being fought all over the world. By listening to the siren, what Babu thought? Babu thought first time that day of the war being fought all over the world. All over the world, the fight is going to be started. And suddenly, coming out of his reverie, just reverie means daydream. He came out of his reverie, daydream. He tensed because a man riding a bike got off and stopped right outside the gate. So just Babu was dreaming. While a person came by motorbike, and got off, stopped right outside the gate, just outside the gate, the bike was parked and stopped. There was a man. Seeing this, he was tensed. But it was only to light a cigarette. Just the person was stopped his vehicle, just lit his cigarette. He was to smoke cigarette, that's why he wanted to light it. It seemed Babu could see the match flaring. The only Babu could. So when the match was flaring, he saw it. Then he glow in the front of the man's face. So when the match was made, he was flaring, he saw his face. When the stick was glowing with the light, he saw his face. The small point of light moved as the man got on his bike and rode away. He lit his cigarette and then he moved up on his way. One more bike. Babu flung himself inside. So one bike went off because he just stopped in front of the gate because he wanted to lit the cigarette. After that, one more bike. So when he saw one more bike, Babu jumped himself inside. So when he saw the one more bike, he jumped inside. Manju turned to be stuttered. She was feared face to see. Someone is coming in. Inferred. Someone is coming in. When the second motorbike came, he jumped out of his place, went to the inside the house and inferred the warning. What was it? Someone is coming in. Someone. Somebody is coming into their house. There was silence. From inside the puja room, their faces looked at him blankly. So, who are sitting in the puja room? Amma, Mohan and Suma. So, they came out of the puja room. Their faces looked at very blankly. They looked at very blankly. The dim light giving them a peculiar look. In the dim light in the puja room gave a peculiar look to those persons. It's a very different look. Shadows quailed and danced on the wake in the oil lamp flickering. Because the oil lamp there was, it was flickering. As a result of the wind, it was flickering. It's flickering like this, the lamp light. So as a result of that, they can see the quail, a darkened wick, and the oil lamp flickering and fizzled. Then Amma got up and come out. So for the pujaram who come out first, Amma come out of the pujaram first. Followed by Mohan and Suman. See, first Amma came out of the pujaram, then Mohan also came, Suman also came. Suman stayed inside. Suman did not come out. Only Amma and Mohan came out of the puja room. Suman stayed there only inside the room. Mohan closed the door. Door of the room. Mohan closed the door. Manju, go to bed. He said, as soon as he came out, Manju, go to bed. Babu, you too go to bed. So we'll see who is coming. What is the matter? We'll see. First you go to bed and take rest. Like this mother and Mohan told the children. So in the next class we are going to see what is happening in the next paragraphs. Thank you very much.